It's that time again, Aussie Tech Head time, episode 261. Welcome, hello listeners, hello viewers in the lounge, live.thesecrethub.com. How are you going? And Eric, how are you going?
Hello, Glennie. Hello, everyone. Good, I'm going well. Weather here is absolute garbage.
Is it raining down there or something?
Oh, we had 3 days of just stinking hot weather, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, 4 days. And it's been raining since Tuesday now.
Yeah, right.
It's just rain, not summer rain, where it's, you know, it's pleasant and it's hot weather, but it's raining. No, it's winter. You'd think it was May. I've got a jumper on.
Yeah, right, right. Well, it's not cold, that cold up here, but it is cooler. The skies are a bit darker. It did have a little bit of a spit, so maybe it's coming up the coast.
Hopefully you'll get it before too much longer.
Yes, so anyway, Aussie Tech Heads, episode 261. This is 27th of October, nearly at the end of another month. You can join us live in the lounge, as I said, live.thesecrethub.com from Queensland time, 7 o'clock, where the Tech Webcast boys come in. We have their show replayed at 7 o'clock. But 7.30 to 7.40, somewhere around there, where Aussie Tech Head starts. So that's Queensland time. Remember that, Queensland time, 7.30. You can call in live to the show if I see Skype pop up on Skype Aussie Tech Ed. Audio only through the Shoutcast system. Pre-recorded video of the show on the YouTube channel, youtube.com/thesecrethub. And paper.aussietechheads.com.au.
Glenn Goodman.haha.
So check the paper out. And Daylight Hour did all that, blah blah blah. You can Will, he's not here, he's still having internet problems. He has been connected to Optus cable, but something's up with his node, and I think you can get cream for that.
What?
Something's up with his node.
Up his node?
No, something's wrong with his node.
Right.
Yes, and so he's getting about 60 meg down and 256k up. So.
Tell him to turn vid blaster.
Something not right there. Something about it. He thinks that it was due to the floods and his little node was submerged.
Oh, a bit of shrinkage. That's no good.
Nah, never any good. Never any good. All right, so we've got a full show. We're going to go through some news that it's come across our desk and we thought was interesting enough to on forward. Now, people don't think that's a word. Is that a proper word, on forward, I ask?
Forward on.
Is that the terminology? Is that the correct?
I have no idea.
Grammatical way of saying it, but I think on forward is now should be in the dictionary. That's a word. Well,
I'll throw it in there with OMG and LOL.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Now, what else is going on? Let's see. How's the stream going? People telling me it's freezing, and it's not just the weather.
No, I'm all right.
Let me have a look on mine. Hang on. I have the technology. To have a look here. Oh, sooner or later. Hang on. Come on. Where are you? Let's have a quick look. And yeah, no, it's still going all right.
It's fine.
You guys down in the ACT.
Yeah, get your own internet connection.
Yeah. Get the NBN.
Yeah, that's right. You're right there next door to Hot Air herself, so get it.
That's right. Well, if we freeze too much, you might be interested in plopping over to QuickFlix. QuickFlix has got a... you know QuickFlix?
Yes,
Eric,
I do.
You ever subscribe to QuickFlix or?
I did years ago. Well, not yeah. What it would have been years ago when we first moved into this place about 8 years ago. We started with their DVD service because you know back then you know show 24 was quite.
Oh
big.
Yes.
I loved that. My wife and I used to watch that. The kids were young. You know, my oldest was only 4, so she'd be in bed early, and my youngest was 2. And the third wasn't even here. So everyone was in bed early and we were able to watch TV.
Yes.
Not anymore.
I remember those days.
Remember those days where you could sleep until at least 6:30 in the morning. But, yeah, and we used to order the DVD, you know, no late fees. You put it on a queue, you put your request in and you get your first one and then you send it back and they give you the second one. So that was all right for a while.
Yeah.
But I would prefer the streaming, obviously.
Yeah, so what's happened is this week, I think it was only this week, QuickFlix has launched an on-demand movie service offering unlimited stream movies for a fixed price. Now, what is the fixed price, you might ask? Well, I'm going to get to that. It's going to cost you $14.99 a month. That's okay. Through bundled packages with their DVD rental service, with prices for the streaming option varying from an additional $7 to $14 per month. So
hang on, let's start again. You what? What?
So the cost of the QuickFlix streaming service on its own will be $14.99.
Right.
Or if you decide to get a bundled package with so streaming and DVD service.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, so it will go from varies from $7 to $14.
That's bizarre. That's really strange. So they're saying if you give us more work to do, we'll charge you less.
Well, yeah, supposedly. Yeah, well,
because it costs money to, just think of the logistics here. I mean, Netflix in the States did the opposite. They were charging $8 a month for DVD and streaming, and they said, you know what? We're trying to push everyone on streaming, so we're going to do this. $7 a month for streaming or $7 a month for DVD or both for $14 if you want that, because it costs money to print the DVD, send it to your post, freight, petrol, greenhouse effect, carbon footprint, all that sort of stuff.
Yes.
And so it tried to stop, motivate people to just use their internet connection. So they increased their prices. And they're doing the opposite here. That's very, very strange.
Yeah, so, I don't know. It's only just been announced. So maybe, I don't know where this article come from. Let's have a quick look. Come from, if.com.au. I think they're pretty with it, aren't they? And
if.com.au, I've never heard of them.
Yeah, no, neither did I until I saw that story. So the company secured deals with studios, including Warner Brothers, International Branded Services, Sony Pictures, Television, Lakeshore Entertainment, Content Media Corporation, and Pinnacle Films. So QuickFlix subscriber base. Now, this is interesting. This shows you how fast this stuff is sort of growing. And also, I don't know if you know, the Telstra movies, they were bought out by, well, not bought out, but were sold off, and QuickFlix bought them. You know, the Big Pond movies?
Yeah, that's what I've ordered a couple from Big Pond.
Mm. So did you have you got a T-Box?
No, but yeah, I have. But you can order it through the Foxtel IQ, the black one, the HD. Oh, yes.
Yep.
That has got an Ethernet cable at the back, so you can order it through that as well.
Oh, okay, right. So what's happening now is just those movies now are just being supplied by QuickFlix. Must be.
I wonder if I order through, because I'm a Big Pond customer, and this would be a question for the chat room. I wonder if it goes towards your bandwidth cap. If you're with Big Pond,
And you what download?
And you rent through QuickFlix.
I don't reckon it does.
Through what you call it?
The Foxtel.
Through Foxtel, it wasn't. It had come down my internet connection, my cable connection, and it would not count towards my cap.
That's right. But you're with Big Pond.
Yes, that's what I mean. For people with Big Pond, I wonder if it counts towards your cap. Since they bought the Big Pond service, I wonder if there's any special deals there.
Well, it doesn't, because I set up a T-Box last weekend and downloaded a movie, and it was free. It was unmetered.
Oh, really? But yes. You don't have a Big Pond connection.
No, it wasn't mine. I set someone else's up.
Yeah. Through the T-Box, it's unmetered, definitely.
Right. But through the Foxtel, you're not sure.
The Foxtel is... through Big Pond Movies, it's unmetered. And T-Box, if you buy Big Pond Movies, it's unmetered.
Yes.
I'm wondering whether or not if I buy a QuickFlix movie through T-Box or Foxtel, whether it will be still unmetered.
Well, I was on the understanding that QuickFlix bought the Big Pond Movies.
Yeah, that's what I'm wondering, whether there's any special deals because, you're an ex-Big Pond Movies customer.
I reckon there'd have to be because unfortunately I don't have a T-Box, so I can't comment either. But there'd have to be. Look, the T-Box is movies. Without the movies, the T-Box is just a piece of
stuff. Yeah, well, you can watch a bit of TV. You can watch free to air,
but use it as a PVR.
Yeah, but who wants to watch free to air over the internet? I use my Foxtel for that. Yeah. I'm going to dick around with a T-Box.
Yeah, that's right. So I don't know. I reckon they'd have to have struck a deal. I reckon it's unmetered. It'd have to be. Otherwise, because you're paying $10 a month for the thing, for the T-Box. But anyway, QuickFlix subscriber base experienced solid growth during September quarter, adding 10,383 new customers. And that's an increase of 15%. And as of October 24, QuickFlix boasted more than 91,500 subscribers. That's pretty good. and that's up 73% year on year. So that's they're big numbers.
You know how many subscribers Netflix has got?
Oh, I'll be in US.
Mm-hmm.
10 million.
25 million.
Yeah, that's a few. That's a few.
That's nearly 10% of the whole population.
Mm.
That's amazing.
Yeah, look, I'm not a big movie person.
I reckon if you could get it on demand, you'd change your mind.
Mm. On demand. Yeah, I don't know. I looked at the T-Box. The movie's standard definition. Bucks? $6 to hire? You know? I don't know.
Well, that's about the same price as a DVD down the shop, but you don't have to get off your ass.
True. There was a HD section on the T-Box.
I think what it does, I know Netflix does this. It when you press record or play or download or rent or whatever, it from their end, it works out what connection you've got and it'll send you the relevant version. So if you've got a really fast connection, it'll automatically send you the HD version.
Yeah, right. Because I noticed that so it downloaded a little bit and then it's enough to get you going and then downloaded in the background. That's right.
Yeah.
So have I finished with that story? Its position in the market has been further, here we go, consolidated by the closure of Big Pond Movies DVD service at the end of last month. We saw Telstra sell the contents of the Big Pond Movies library to QuickFlix. So there you go.
How do we stream this? Is there a box? What can you stream it through?
What, QuickFlix?
Yeah.
At the moment, it's going to be... Did it say... was it a...
Rent, here we go. Has launched first online streaming rental service via Sony's new range of internet-connected TVs.
That's right. And I think it's going to progressively roll out to other platforms and even the Xbox next year.
Xbox and PlayStation as well. It'll have to go to PlayStation being a Sony.
Yeah. I think it launched. It's already launched on the Bravia. Blu-ray players and home theater systems will then allow be a wider access through PC and Mac computers from November 10. So not too long to wait.
Not too long.
It's got to be a bit bit of a rival to Foxtel though, hasn't it?
Oh, yeah. The Foxtel, a lot of the old fogies are still using Foxtel.
It's internet stuff.
But I guess the Foxtel's got different movies. They've signed up to different music houses, haven't they? So that's all.
Yeah, they have for now. But, eventually QuickFlix will sign up with all the majors, I'm assuming, just like Netflix did. And that's threatening the cable operators in America.
Mm. Yeah. Yeah, well, so keeping in with the media theme of things, Microsoft unveils Zune Music Pass and voice commands for the Kinect.
Only for the Kinect?
The new service called Zune Music Pass will be available in Australia from November 16 for the Windows Phone, PC and Xbox 360. Streaming music services offering more than 11 million downloadable tracks for $11.99 a month. And today, Microsoft unveiled a voice command system to complement Kinect. It will be available locally for applications such as Zune Movies by mid-December. So maybe...
Everyone's on the Siri. Everyone's shaking in their boots. Oh, my God, we've got to do something with this voice thing. Siri, Apple's all over us.
Yeah. Oh, Siri's good. Siri's pretty good. But I was surprised to learn through the week that it doesn't train. It's not a trainable...
Yeah, that is surprising. But look, that's remember too, Siri, when they released it, they specifically said it is in beta.
Yeah, yeah.
So we'll see what happens.
Yeah. So look, I think if you're into movies, I think streaming them is going to be the way to go, isn't it? The music, $12 a month.
I've been dying for that to come out for a while, but because I'm surprised Apple didn't jump on that.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, they try to, don't they? Didn't they buy out a little bloody streaming service somewhere?
They bought out. I can't remember the name of it now.
They bought out someone.
Somebody. Yeah.
Oh yeah, I can't remember it either. Yeah. But $12 a month, any song you want to listen to.
Well, in the States, their deal is it's. I think it's about the same price. I think it's $10 a month. We always get screwed here. The old bloody technology tax. But in the States, it was $10 a month and unlimited songs, download, as long as you keep subscribing. But every month, you got to keep 10 songs.
Right.
So you could download 100 songs, but and you could get to keep 10 songs. So if you just say, for example, signed up for a year,
yep,
and 10 songs a month, that's 120 songs, and you stopped.
Yep. You keep them.
You get 120 songs and all the other ones, and if you download 1,000 in total, then you, you know, you don't get to keep the other 800, 900 songs.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, so that's not bad. So each song works out to be a dollar each.
It's interesting to see that that Microsoft have launched this in Australia, the Zoom Music Pass. Like, mum and dad are going to go, what the hell's Zoom?
Shouldn't they just call it Music Pass?
Yeah, Xbox Music Pass or Windows something. Music Pass.
Yeah, that's right.
Live that Music Pass.
People can identify with.
Yeah, that's right.
You notice that they've all only at the moment released it for the PC, not the Mac.
Oh yeah, but apparently commands include play. This is the speech recognition. Play, fast forward, and stop. And there are also commands for navigating through Xbox menus and Xbox Live systems. Voice control within games will be available later in the week. So that only leaves tomorrow from the Microsoft's Kinect Sports Season 2. So voice control within games will be available. Okay, so Microsoft have also released more games for the Kinect on Xbox 360. Dance Central 2, Kinect Disneyland Adventures, Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary, and Forza Sports. So there you go. Look, yeah. I had to play with the Kinect. Have you ever played with the Kinect?
No, I haven't.
Oh, that's like you're in The Matrix or whatever it was called. What was that film called? With Tom Cruise?
What? Not? Oh, no. What's it called? That one.
That one.
Minority Report.
That's him, where he's going like this and whipping it all around.
Did you feel like Tom Cruise?
I did.
Did you turn around and pass Nicole Kidman?
I couldn't find her. I'm waiting for the 3D version.
Couldn't find her, too much Botox.
Yeah, oh, well, she was too pale. She paled into the wall.
Blended in.
Yeah. All right. What any stories that you picked up?
Well, what did I pick up during the week? Let me just click on my little... No, look at that.
What's happened?
My stories have disappeared. Oh. I know. Look, that sounds like someone. I'm not going to say who. But that's awful.
All right. Well, I can tell you another story.
I'll be happy to comment on your stories, Glenn.
Okay. Well, here you can have a comment on this one. Now, the states are to establish, or Sydney and Melbourne at present, the governments of New South Wales and Victoria are seeking to register the .Sydney, .Melbourne and the .Victoria strings and potentially .New South Wales. ICANN will accept round one applications for new GTLDs from next January to April, charging a fee of, have a guess how much a dot Sydney's going to cost you.
Oh, I can see it here. So, hang on. Are they buying the right to give out dot Sydney or dot Melbourne or whatever?
No, they want to keep it.
And they can on-sell the individual domains. You know what I mean? Are they? Is this the price for, I'm wondering... is for the head domain. So we can have .Sydney, right? Yep. 185,000, that's what you're going to say.
Yes.
But then when they, if you want, you know, .Queensland, you know, Glenn Goodwin .Queensland, surely you wouldn't be paying 185,000. Wouldn't they just be selling it off at 50 bucks a pop or something?
Well, no, they're not going to be selling them off. That's the thing. They want to keep them because of their... their trademark. Value or their potential tourism, you know, they don't want someone to come along and do, you know, XXX.Sydney or something like that, I suppose.
King's Cross.Sydney.
Well, that'll be there because that's Ridgy Didge. But
I don't know how Ridgy Didge is. Have you noticed that they've got the conversion wrong again?
180,000 is 185 US. No, that's right.
No, it's not. No.
185,000 US.
Maybe it is.
Yeah, because the Australian's lower, so that one's right.
No, it's higher, mate. It's higher now. It's $1.05 today.
Yeah, so it costs us less to buy more.
So 180,000 Aussie. Yeah,
I think that's around the right way this time.
Yeah. That's right. It's right. Congratulations. journalist who wrote that. You got it right.
Now something else that came up through the week, or especially when I was doing the stories. Now, I don't know if you came across this or not, but the good old News Corporation, they've started their paywalls.
I haven't tried it. You mentioned it earlier. I just wonder how many people are going to jump on this. What's the deal? You know how sometimes you say if you're a subscriber to the newspaper, you know, you get it delivered and you pay your monthly fee.
Yeah.
Do you get the paywall as a freebie, or do you got to pay for that too? I wonder.
Now, if you subscribe to the paper, you get the complimentary digital version.
Right.
Yes.
Well, a few years ago, I was a subscriber to, a few months ago, I was a subscriber to the Financial Review. But if you wanted to join, if you wanted to log into their Financial Review website and you're a subscriber, you had to pay another $30 a month, another on top of.
Yeah.
So I said, no, hey. Yeah. In the end, I rang them and I said, oh, look, I've been buying Financial Review for, 15 years, every day for 15 years. What's the story? Mm. Oh, you're going to have to pay extra. I said, right, I'm canceling my subscription.
Yeah.
The whole lot.
Yeah, look. News can be news is freely available. I don't know what the Australian has announced. Anyway, the Australian has announced it will launch digital subscription. Launch it on Monday with a 3-month free trial for all readers. So what happens is you look at a story, you might get the first two paragraphs, and then you either got to log in to get the rest, and obviously pay. So they're going to charge readers $2.95 a week, for a basic digital subscription. Combination packages including print and digital subscriptions will cost up to $7.95 a week. Existing 6-day-a-week print subscribers will receive this complimentary, so that's cool. And the company indicated it would allow users to access up to 5 premium content stories a day via Google and have 1 free click-through from social media sites like Facebook.
They're going to monitor this, really.
They're going to jam little cookies on your system.
Yeah, well, good luck trying that on my system.
Yeah, well, that's what you meant. You just flush your cookies.
Yeah, flush cookies, exactly.
Yeah, flush.
I just put on there, it says accept cookies, never.
Yeah, that's another way to do it.
Yeah, that's it. So there's a lesson for the kiddies. Never accept cookies on the news site.
No, that's right.
The Wall Street Journal, which is owned by News Corp now, have done the same thing. They've had it for about a year. I don't know how well it's going or not. And, you get the standard stuff. You click on it and you get, first two paragraphs and then a little pop-up saying, please subscribe, blah, 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 blah. Give us your firstborn child and we'll give you access.
Mm. Look, I know, I do get a lot of stories from The Australian, and it's just because it's just higher in my news list feed than IT News Australia. Yeah. That's the only reason.
Right. Yeah.
So, and if I wanted real news, current affairs and all that sort of stuff, with all the current headaches going on around the world with news of the world and all the mobile phone rubbish and all this sort of stuff, well, you'd be going to someone that's impartial, like the BBC news site. That'd be one of the best sites to go to.
Well, I like news.google.com because that aggregates all the stories.
Yeah,
some of them to pay for and others you don't, but and you can pick which country: Australia, US, Pakistan, whatever, Hong Kong, Singapore, you name it, and you can pick news.google.hk or something, and it's got world news and region news, so it's not bad.
So I just flashed up a screenshot of news.google.com, and so down there you go, click on the Australia tag, and there you go, man jailed for tying up Costa's wife. What? He's brave? Oh, that's Costa. I thought I was talking about Costa Zoo. I was going to go get his head punched in.
No.
That's all going. Yeah, right. Then, so blah, blah, blah. So, news.google.com. That looks pretty. I haven't really gone to that too much, but that does look pretty comprehensive. That doesn't look too bad there, Eric.
Yeah, and if you go down, you can prick the, whatever region you want to go there to. It's not too bad.
Yeah, down the side there. Yeah, that's good. All right. Now, what's going on? Now, you downloaded an audio book through the week.
I did. And
so did I, as it happened.
I'm surprised, actually.
I know, and I fear it's the same one.
I fear you're correct.
And fear because I have delved into the Apple world even further.
The reality distortion field has got you.
It has. I can't escape. I can see the edge. I'm on the inside.
I ordered the audio version from Audible. Thank you.
Yes.
I pre-ordered it. So I woke up the next day and it's already on my bloody iPad. Yeah. It just downloaded.
I didn't do it as easy as that. I had to go and do it manually, but yes.
All right. Okay. Well, I just went onto Amazon, Kindle books, audio books on audible.com, pre-order, bang, and it just charges you when it comes down. Then I went to Amazon, Kindle book, you know, the paperback version, but electronic, so I can read my iPad.
Yes.
And pre-ordered, bang, that. And I've got, then I ordered the iBook version as well.
So you're paying for all these?
Yeah, I'm paying for all this.
So why did you want so many versions?
Just for posterity's sake.
Couldn't you just cut and paste one Saturday afternoon?
What's that?
Cut and paste one Saturday, one rainy Saturday afternoon.
Oh, God, no. Take forever. Then I ordered the hardback cover as well.
Oh, my God.
Amazon. So one for the that one's purely for the bookcase.
Yeah.
The hardback.
Yeah.
And, because it's pre-ordered, we got it before the Americans did, because we hit October 24 before they did.
Yes, right. Yes. Yep.
And wake up the next day and it basically says, now downloading. Bang, there it was. And, it's very – look, there's a lot of in there that I know about because of the previous non-official biographies that have been written on him, on Mr. Jobsy.
Yep.
But some of the insight, because now it's coming direct from him, and he pretty much admits – that he was, to put it lightly, a royal pain in the ass.
Yes.
In a lot of areas, it makes it more, makes it more not just believable, but because you know now it's coming from the horse's mouth, but it makes it more real. It makes it more believable. It makes it you sort of feel sorry for the guy on one hand, but you don't on the other hand. So it's a sort of a bit of a roller coaster.
Because
you hate him 1 minute and you think, oh God, what a prick.
Yeah, because I've only like just started. I'm probably about 20 minutes into it, and one of the thing I don't know because I watched the YouTube thing, and now I might be getting mixed up between the actual book and the YouTube video I watched. But one of the mean things that he did, and I'd like to know more about it, and I'd like to delve further into it, to why he was so mean, was one of the originators or original guys in the shed when they created the Apple II,
Daniel Kotke.
Yeah, got no shares in the company.
Yeah, what happened there? No, that's a true story. What happened there is that they were working on this project. I think it was on the Macintosh. And, they were they worked 3 weeks and they said, oh, we need 2 months. They said, no, well, you've got 3 weeks or you've got 2 weeks to do it. And so they worked day and night, him and a couple of others and two or three others or whoever, I don't know how many, worked on it. And they were exhausted. So they went to sleep. They went home. They went to sleep, had a few hours sleep. Came back to the office, and then he's because I've just passed this section in the book, and then he said, "Oh, look, I want something else for the demo. I want you to give it a speech thing, like welcome, I'm the Macintosh, that sort of thing."
Yeah.
If you look on YouTube, you'll actually see that presentation of the Mac and what they did. Hello, I'm Macintosh, blah blah blah. So they had to do that, and they said, "Oh, you've got to do that by tomorrow." So they all rushed around and did it and everything like this, and so this guy went home. So when they were handing out bonuses, he was handing everyone out $50,000 or something. This was before the float, just before the float. Mm. They were handing out bonuses. Because he wasn't there, he didn't get his bonus.
So why did he go home?
Because he was exhausted. He hadn't slept for freaking 3 weeks.
So, okay, so he never got it.
He never got it. And he was and he went to he went to him and he was crying and not fair and all this sort of stuff. And basically he's saying, oh, look, I don't have time to this, go away sort of thing. And that's not nice.
But apparently was it one of the other guys, they were all feeling sorry for this guy because he was left out because they all had received, portions of shares or some money or whatever.
Yeah. That was later on. And in the end, the same thing happened to him again. And not just him. There was a few others that were there from the beginning that got absolutely nothing.
Yeah, and wasn't it? And then Jobsy, one of the guys, came up to Jobs and said, "Listen, I will put in some money to this. I'll give this guy some money."
Steve Wozniak, the other co-founder, said, "Look, I'll give him. I think he deserves $800,000 worth of shares. And how about we go halves?" And yeah. Steve Jobs said, yeah, I'll go halves with you. You give him nothing, I'll give him nothing.
That's shit, especially if the guy's done nothing but you know, help program. Like, fair enough if he's, you know, going on crazy like a pork chop or something. But
a lot of them went crazy. And look, he was just very, I think, very arbitrary in his allocation of. Well, you know, back then too, when they first floated, there was no, for example, now that most public companies have what they call a remuneration committee, or you know, employee shares options committee. And people like the chief executive can't be on that committee. It's got to be completely impartial. A lot of the time it's non-executive directors, people who don't actually work there, but they're on the board.
Yeah, yeah.
So they can be remain, you know, as objective as possible. But, you know, when you're about to float, there's no objectivity because everybody works there. And the guy that's doling out the shares is the guy that runs the place. So if he doesn't like you, you're not getting shit.
Well, he obviously mustn't have liked. It wasn't just it couldn't have been just a case that, oh, well, he went home early exhausted, so too bad, too sad.
Oh, look, that. I'm sure it was more than that. But, you know, him being Steve what, you know, how can you justify that? And how could you even begin to understand that?
Didn't like his haircut. But anyway. No, so have you got any audio?
I do have audio.
So now where did you get your audio from?
I got it from Audible.
Audible.com. Now, you can't buy the whole book of Steve Jobs for free, but you could get a portion of it for free.
I think maybe you can, one credit. I'm sure is this worth two credits, this book?
I think it's worth two.
Oh, yeah, because it's a long book. It's 25 hours.
Yeah, so it's, so just go, for more information, just go to the aussietechheads.com.au or just go to the website aussietechheads.com.au. There's an Audible link down there. Click on the Audible link, and then once you get into there, search for your book and sign up, and away you go. You get the first book free or one credit free. So whatever, you know, whatever that means.
Get the paper.
That's right. But look, yeah, it does go for 25 hours and 10 minutes. Pity the guy that had to sit there and read it. How often do you reckon, how many hours a day do you reckon he reads for, like, to do it? 2 hours?
I think the general consensus is if it's a 25-hour book, it's taken 50 hours worth of recordings.
They
edit it and all that sort of stuff. And they say, stop there, say it like this, and or that didn't come out clearly and all that sort of stuff.
Yeah, right. Yep. So if you don't want to sign up and get the free credit, you can buy it for $34.99. That'd be US. I'm just looking at their website.
I got mine for a lot cheaper than that.
Yeah, now look, I saw it when I was doing it today, when I was just preparing for tonight. I'm sure I saw it. I thought it was cheaper than that too. I thought it was 20 something. And then
are you going to Amazon, audible.com.au or audible.com?
I'm on .com.
Okay. Well, I got it for $26.99.
I think that might have been the price, yes. Mm. Yeah. But anyway, why is there, do you know why there's two in the store? They look exactly the same.
One's probably unabridged and one's abridged.
No, they're both unabridged. But anyway, there is one abridged. But anyway, it doesn't matter. The abridged one goes for 9 hours and 7 minutes.
Oh, you don't want that. No. That doesn't tell you anything.
If you're going to buy it, why would you buy unabridged? You can always fast forward it.
Unless you've got lazy ears.
That's right. But anyway, shoot us up some audio of, what's his name? Dylan Baker, the narrator. Or did you get the first part, the intro by Walter?
You want me to do the intro by Walter?
Oh, whatever you've got queued.
I'm going straight into part two.
All right.
Let's see how this...
Dylan. Dylan Baby.
Hang on.
So
he went to a party that Yoko Ono threw for her son, Sean Lennon, and gave the 9-year-old a Macintosh. The boy loved it. The artists Andy Warhol and Keith Haring were there, and they were so enthralled by what they could create with the machine that the contemporary art world almost took an ominous turn. "I drew a circle," Warhol exclaimed proudly after using Quick Draw. Warhol insisted that Jobs take a computer to Mick Jagger. When Jobs arrived at the rock star's townhouse, Jagger seemed baffled. He didn't quite know who Jobs was. Later, Jobs told his team, "I think he was on drugs. Either that or he's brain damaged." Jagger's daughter, Jade, however, took to the computer immediately and started drawing with Mac Paint. So Jobs gave it to her instead.
There you go. There you go. Little bit.
He was nice to children.
Oh, look, he was I just used to laugh because I hate to admit this, but I can be a little bit like this. And someone will, you know, there was no gray with this bloke. It was either you were either just Superman and you were the best thing since sliced bread, or you were garbage.
Yes.
Yeah. You know? And some of the sayings, like as you read through the book, and if you're only about 20 minutes in, you're just going to laugh. I mean, it's so mean, but you will laugh because the same. He's a bit of a Paul Keating.
Yeah, right, that, yes.
The vitriolic, the just, this is, you know, bleeping crap, you know. Yeah. And he's, you know, this is, you know, before he even sees something, he'll go up to, I don't know, Microsoft or Intel and go, your stuff's crap.
Oh, yeah, well, that's fair enough. He got things done, didn't he?
Oh, he got things done. Look, let's not make any bones about it. The guy was not a saint. There's no doubt about it. I'm no Apple fanboy. I'm no Steve Jobs, and I can't see, you know, the forest from the trees, or the trees from the forest, whatever you want to call it. The guy had many, many flaws. This, you know, and he even admits that.
Mm.
But like all geniuses, they're all highly flawed, all of them.
Yeah.
And you can't, and that's just the way it is. You know, Albert Einstein was the same.
And it's
they
a,
all are.
Yeah, it's a good listen. So if you,
Picasso was the same.
Yeah, it's a good listen. So if you're into Jobsy, into Apple, it is a really good listen. You pick up things that you never would have thought about before. But say, for example, you know, through the first part of the 20 minutes I've listened to, you know, they described the house he lived in. Normal street, normal backyard, no fence. Just rock up to his front door, knock on it. Hello, how you going, Steve?
Said that he left the back door open. You could walk through the back door into the kitchen.
So stuff like that is just, you know, just information that's just, yeah, cool. That's a good part of him, I suppose. But anyway, if you want to have a look at that book, go to Audible. AussieTechHeads.com.au and click on the Audible link and get your goodness from there. Now let's go on to a film, Angry Birds. Ooh, what's that? Pirates? Is that the DVD?
Yeah.
Hang on, let me give you the full screen there. There you go. I've got that. I've got in a nice little flash cover though.
Have you watched it?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's not too bad, isn't it?
Yeah, it's all right. It's pretty. Oh, it's entertaining. Yeah, it's good. That's good. But it's funny.
Don't you reckon Bill Gates played a real sleazy bastard?
Yeah, I suppose. I haven't seen it for ages. But yeah. Look,
I haven't seen it for ages either. And I went and I thought, oh, where's that bloody thing? It was in my office.
Yeah, right.
You know, I've been listening to Jobsy. It was in my office, and I went right to the office and grabbed it. It's been sitting there for bloody 3 years.
Yeah.
And
it's a good. That's a good view as well. That's a good watch. What was I going to say about that? Yeah, but it's just intriguing that, you know, Jobs he first started out with what do they call it? They called it freaking or hacking or something. Where he made their little
phone freaking.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. And it was to get free phone calls.
The blue box.
So he's like a pirate. Started off a pirate. Now he doesn't like it.
Now, hates pirates.
Now he wants to spend every last dollar in Apple's kitty, which is now about $81 billion, on destroying Android. But anyway.
It should, because Android's garbage. There you go. Said it.
Go and listen to the book. That's good. Angry
Frosty. Well done, Frosty. Go get it, mate. I hope you clicked on the link and I'll go to Tasmania and punch your head in.
Yeah. And I'll come too.
I'll fly you down there.
Okay. All right. Now, Angry Birds. Yeah, we all know what Angry Birds is. Of course we do.
Yeah, but why are they doing this?
Okay, why are they doing what? They are...
Who's going to play the main bird?
Oh, Big Bird? I don't know. I don't know. Woody Woodpecker might get a start.
Oh,
revive him. Rovio's North American General Manager Andrew Stalbo said that they were working hard on the movie. Now, Rovio, which is the company that created... Angry Birds, based in Finland. They recently bought...
Is it animation?
Yeah, recently...
It's got to be animation, right?
Recently bought an animation studio based in Helsinki. Now, he's big... So I would imagine it's from the little graphic I've got here that described the story from where I read it from. It's going to be an animation, so I would say so. You couldn't have a... Who would you have? Like, you know...
Hey, Leonardo, put this bird suit on.
Yeah.
Well, not going to happen.
What about Les Patterson might get a start? What happened to Les anyway?
Dame Edna Angry.
Les Angry Patterson. What about Angry Anderson? He's a shoo-in.
Oh, he's a shoo-in. He was. Who'd play the pig? Well, that'd be Simon Crean or Bill Shorten.
All right. Yeah. And so Aldrich Dallo Rovio said, our big ambitious goal at the company is to have 1 billion fans. The growth has been very strong, but they've only just started, he said. So, yeah, so that's their ambition. So, yeah, I don't know. Look, I just put that in for a bit of fun. Like, it's not something I'd probably go and see. I'd probably watch 5 minutes of it.
I've got Angry Birds on the Mac.
Oh, I like the game, but it's, I don't know if I'd dedicate 2 hours to, or 1.5 hours to watching it. But anyway.
No way. No. Not, well, I don't know. Who knows? I mean, obviously Pixar didn't want to make it.
Yeah. Now, how about this bloke?
Which bloke?
This bloke, Max Schrems. However you say that. But anyway.
Max Schrems?
This is him.
Oh, German. Mr. German.
I don't know. He sounds German. Let's see if we can push him up a bit there. There he is. Now, all I've got to say is that's Max. And he wasn't sure what he would get when he asked Facebook to send him a record of his personal data from his 3 years of using Facebook, of using the site.
3 years? That's all I've been using it for.
He's Austrian. Max Schrems, the Austrian law student, didn't expect... was 1,222 pages of data on a CD. It included chats he had deleted more than a year ago, pokes dating back to 2008, invitations to which he had never responded, and let alone attended, and hundreds of other details. Now, Schrems also disputes that Facebook has given him all of the information it holds, arguing that he's only received information from 23 out of a possible 57 data categories. Facebook insists it has given Schrems and others in his group all of the information that is legally required. Facebook insists it is allowed to...
There's the rub, that is legally required.
Yes, and that's what's stupid, isn't it?
Yeah.
Facebook insists it is allowed to... See, and also with this is... do they go through it and, black out other people's personal details? Or just delete, you know? Like a freedom of information inquiry, you know.
I would want to do it manually. I pity the poor bastard that has to do that job. I'd say that's probably an algorithm that they've created. Yeah.
Facebook insists it's allowed to hold back data that includes a range of other things that are not personal information, including Facebook's proprietary fraud protection measures and any other analytical procedure that Facebook runs. Now, what I found as equally as disturbing as all the information that got sent to this dude. I'll just flash this picture up again. What's the first thing you do when you get 1,222 pages of information on a CD? What's the first thing you do?
Not print it like he's done.
He's printed it out.
What an idiot.
What a forehead slap.
That is a massive forehead slap. Have you seen a lamp in the background? What the hell is that? I had a lamp like that when I was 15.
He can't afford a proper lamp because he spends all his money on paper.
Well, he's just run out of ink for the rest of the year.
How is that? Look at it. 1,222 pages sitting on his desk. That's stupid. Why would you print it out?
How have your carbon footprint now, buddy boy?
Yeah. What's going on, buddy Austrians?
You wouldn't even, you'd file it away, wouldn't you? You wouldn't even look at it.
You wouldn't.
Why would you want it?
It's probably just to make it look like, you know, as a demonstration on how much it is. Couldn't he just get I don't know, 10 reams of it and just say...
Yeah, you just put 10 reams, say, look, this is what it is, and it'll make it look like it, and put the sheet on the top would have some writing on it.
Yeah, yeah, that's
right. Maybe that's what he's done.
No way. Because all
throw the picture up again.
Because all the paper, that's all been handled. It looks like you wouldn't put that back in a printer. So, no.
Yeah, yeah, he's a forehead slap for sure.
Forehead slap Schrems.
FSS. There you go.
You're gone.
You're a goner.
All right. Now, the ASX. What happened to the ASX today? Does anybody know?
They had a glitch.
They had a meltdown.
I don't understand that. Look, they didn't say what happened. All it says was they had a connectivity issue.
Yes.
I mean, geez, I have connectivity issues.
We had one tonight.
ASX should not have connectivity issues. What happened with their, don't they have backup systems and redundant connections and, you know, all the, I've got a redundant connection, for God's sake.
All systems
were put into a state of inquire at 10, that's just at the opening too.
10:05.
10:05 at the opening.
Don't they open till 10 o'clock, the lazy mongrels?
No, they open it. Yeah, they go to 10 till 4.
Oh, have a bit of a sleep in, do they? Nice.
Well, they're all working, but the market doesn't open till 10. They're all there earlier than that, I would hope.
So anyway, opened at 10, shut down into a state of inquiry at 10:05. ASX technical staff investigated the issue with software vendor NASDAQ, OMX. Ooh. A spokesman for the exchange explained that a connectivity issue with the ASX trading system caused some brokers to be unable to transact. So because there were some that weren't able to transact, they just shut the whole thing down, just to be fair to everybody. So now I want to ask you a question.
Go on.
Now, with these stock exchanges, now, it was only a couple of years ago I learnt there was like a Newcastle Stock Exchange.
Yeah, I think it's, and I could be stood corrected. I think it's called the secondary market for smaller companies.
Right. And then there's another one coming online.
Yeah, I can't remember the name of that one. What's that one called, do you know?
It's a Chinese one or something?
No. Well, yeah, in China.
No, it's coming online in Australia. It's, it's something else. That's a new stock. But anyway, what I wanted to know was, so there's obviously allowed to be more than one stock exchange. Do they all have the same shares, or do they each have to have their own one?
They have their own. I want the Newcastle Stock Exchange now. It says here, NSX is a stock exchange established specifically for the listing of company, property, and debt securities. So company security, property security, I think. Now, who's listed? Here we go. Let's have a look who's listed. Australian United Retailers, Preference Shares, Australian Premier Finance Holdings, International Holdings. They're all fairly small. There's a few of them on there.
So, and then the NSX.
That's called the NSX.
Oh, that's,
yeah,
that's the Newcastle one.
Yeah, Newcastle, right. Yeah.
There is a new one coming.
Yes, what is that called, do you know?
I can't see it, no, but I did read about it. But anyway, just as well this wasn't a business show.
Yeah, just as well, because I haven't read up on it.
No, but there is a new one coming, and they're saying that, you know, this is all playing into the hands of the new one, because, you know, people lose faith, you know, blah, blah, blah. But anyway, I can't find it. But anyway, it doesn't matter.
I might list myself on here just to raise some money.
Yeah, can you just list yourself, can you?
No, you'd have to list. I'm sure they've got criteria that you have to follow.
Oh, really?
Oh, damn it.
That's no good. All right, so from the ASX, let's go over to Commonwealth Bank. Now, what have they been up to? Do you know what they've been up to?
Nothing.
I'll tell you.
Nothing.
Hang on, the dog just sneezed. Commonwealth Bank is the first commercial NFC provider in Australia.
There it is. Yeah, I saw that.
Now, what is NFC, you might say? It's near field communication. Commonwealth Bank said it would launch a full commercial near field communication payment system built around the iPhone and MasterCard's PayPass contactless payment platform.
Huh? Wave and go. Have you got one of these Wave and Go credit cards?
Yes.
Yeah, I've got one.
I don't know if I like them, but I've got one.
I haven't used it. I've had a chance to use it.
Oh, I like using it. I just mean I don't know about what's stopping you from walking down the street and someone with a merchant in their pocket,
That's what I was going to say. You say someone's, you know how they've got those ATM skimmers, those crooks that skim the ATMs, right?
Yeah.
They put those little things behind the machine and then you put your card in and you get money out and they read everything and they go down 5 minutes later and empty your account. What's to stop skimmers from sidling up to you in a bus stop and you wouldn't even know?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
And they just, you know.
Yes. Yeah.
Just, so I use my credit cards in a normal fashion, you know, online.
Yeah. Yeah, look, that's all right. That's good. That the new mobile banking, what is it? The Wave and Go mobile payment system has been interrogated and integrated into the Commonwealth's upcoming mobile market app, blah, 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 blah. And new iPhone app called Kaching. I guess that's how you say it. K-A-C-H-I-N-G.
I think it's called Kaching.
Oh, Kaching.
Yeah. Which is a stupid name, because it's basically saying, you know, when someone says Kaching, it means you're being ripped off, right?
Yeah.
Or you pay too much. Ka-ching. Or you know, it's a connotation of excess. So what was a marketing genius that came out of that? Obviously, no one that's ever worked at Apple.
The new mobile banking application contains a contactless payment function that works with the NFC chip built into a casing the bank has designed for newer models of the iPhone.
But the iPhone doesn't have an NFC chip.
No, but it's built into the case. Like they're going to give you a case.
Oh, right. Okay. So if you've got a case that's got this chip in it, it'll clip onto the iPhone.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
So it'll have to. So the case will have to. It'll probably be through their USB connector.
I'm not sure how it would work.
How would it clip in?
Maybe Bluetooth.
You know, some of the iPhone batteries. Some of the iPhone, you know, those extended batteries.
Yes.
That you can get for the iPhone. Well, you slide that into a USB. You know, you slides in, bang, and it's the USB of the iPhone sits in the USB connector of the case.
Right.
And that you get your charge. Assuming it'll be something similar.
Yeah.
It'll just slide in, and then it'll just read the fact that there's
It's not called a USB though. It's just the iPhone connector.
Well, yeah, it's USB, mate.
It'll just piggyback the USB. Yeah, so CBS are currently around 42,000 NFC readers rolled out in Australian retail merchant facilities. The banks also said that chip makers around the world were setting on orders for 500 million NFC chips, which are destined for the handsets. Commonwealth Bank...
Who ordered those? Android?
Probably they'd order a few. Commonwealth Bank probably orders three. CBA said it would make its iPhone casing available free to customers wishing to use the NFC system.
I bet they would, because then they'll be saying ka-ching.
Yeah, that's right. It was in what it was described as a world first in mobile banking. The Commonwealth also revealed that ka-ching would offer consumer to consumer mobile payment via SMS, email, and Facebook.
That I don't mind.
That's pretty cool.
Because you can control that.
Yeah. CBA customers that register their mobile number with their bank accounts can instantly transfer money to each other using the SMS system. Kaching is currently only available on the iPhone. However, it is understood that CBA has started developing for Android. And Woolworths has committed to rolling out contactless readers across its supermarkets. Big W department stores, Dick Smith, Caltex, and BWS, Dan Murphy's, and Woolworths, Liquor. Outlets. Liquor. That's right.
Good one.
Now, I've got one more. Have you got anything to say before I do my last one?
I've got plenty to say, but I'm not going to say it.
Don't forget, Chew the Fat, after Aussie Tech Ads, all available as a single download for those of you listening to us on podcast, Chewing the Fat with Eric and myself, where we talk a bit more, I don't know.
What are we going to talk about today?
Irreverently about other topics.
That's right. Who are we going to slag off today?
I don't know what we'll do tonight, but obviously we've got a few up our sleeve, so stay tuned, live.thesecrethub.com for that.
Or
look in the, what's your youtube.com/net channel number 2.
The number 2, yes.
All right. Now, I've got one last little story here, and if I can find it. What? Now, here it is. Now, I don't know if I've actually got... Oh, don't tell me I've lost the thing. But anyway, oh, that's a shame.
What have you lost? Which story was it?
No, I haven't lost the story, but I've lost the picture. But anyway, doesn't matter. I can look for it in a second. Apple objects to a German cafe trademark. Now, Apple thought... Now, remember when Woolworths changed their logo?
Yeah, why did they change their logo?
Oh, yeah, times change, things get old. Change as good as a holiday. Woolworths looked a bit like Westpac back then. I don't know. Change as good as a holiday. You know, some guy in the marketing department probably needed a pay rise, so he thought, well, let's change the logo. That's what I did for the place this year. I get a pay rise.
John, I'm just reading here. Yeah. Apple thought.
So Apple thought, so with the Woolworths logo, okay, so the Woolworths logo was too similar to its own. Since Woolworths application included use of the trademark in Class 9, which covers data processing equipment and computers. Why would they do this? Why would Woolworths trademark in Class 9, which covers...
Because they own Dick Smith. But that's Woolworths doesn't own Dick... Well, they own Dick Smith, but Woolworths itself is not trading in data processing equipment, computers. They're just being idiots.
Yeah.
You're idiots.
But Woolworths was granted trademark registration number 1258297, and so Apple lost the argument. So now what's happened is Apple, they're pretty protective about things, aren't they? Now
lose it is the law.
Yeah, but very protective. Like, I don't know. Would you have thought that the Woolworths logo would be?
No.
Like,
look, thing like an apple.
Yeah, that's right. I'm just going to get
like
this.
Look like a fresh bunch of lettuce.
I just want to get this little picture up. So now Apple is taking on a smaller business over in Germany. There's a privately owned cafe in Bonn, B-O-N-N, Germany, called Apple Child, spelt A-P-F-E-K-I-N-D, which has applied to register a trademark consisting of a picture of an apple with a child's face, silhouetted face. Now, I'll show you for those on the lounge. That's what Apple's blowing about. But it's nothing like it. They're a cafe. I don't understand.
It looks like the apple. There's not even a bite on it. It's just an apple. You cannot trademark a piece of fruit.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. And, so there you go. How do you like that? How do you like them apples?
Red apple? I'm partial to red apples. I used to like green apples.
No. I like the red ones. I used to like the green ones, the Granny Smiths, but now I like the delicious ones or whatever they're called.
Ooh, yum.
Ooh, yeah, yummy, yum, yum. All right, well, that's just about done. Me, are you done? Stick a fork in you. I think you're done.
I'm done. Now, stay tuned for Chewing the Fat because I was going to play a Johnny Ives' speech.
Oh, yes, you wanted to do something. Did you want to do this on Aussie Tech Heads?
We can do it through Chewing the Fat if you wish, or you can do it now. Are you running overtime?
No, we can do it now if you want. You can intro it if you want. Do you want to intro it or just play it?
Yeah, you just play it. This is during the week, they had a memorial for the Apple employees for Steve Jobs. I think it was October 19 they had it. And it goes for over an hour, but I edited the Johnny Ives' speech, and it's quite good, and you should have a listen. It's on, and if you want to see the whole thing, you can go to Apple's website, apple.com, not AU, apple.com, or go to YouTube and just type in Steve Jobs Celebration, and the full thing is on there.
Right.
But this is the edited version of Johnny Ives' speech.
So this little edited version goes for a little while as well, so we might just play a little bit, and then we'll break, and then we'll end the show, and then we'll... You can see the full video that Eric's done, the full edit, youtube.com/net channel2. Okay. So let's have a little listen to this little fella. When the internet loads up. Come on, internets. You can do it.
Here's that sound.
Love it.
Steve used to say to me, and he used to say this a lot. Hey, Johnny, here's a dopey idea. And sometimes they were. Really dopey. Sometimes they were truly dreadful. But sometimes they took the air from the room. And they left us both completely silent. Bold, crazy, magnificent ideas. Or quiet, simple ones. Which in their subtlety, their detail, they were utterly profound.
All right, we're going to leave it there.
Loved ideas.
Stop that. You stop it, Johnny. because there's a bit of noise in there. So anyway, so that's it. So you can go to youtube.com/netchannel2 and you can see Eric's edit to just the Johnny
Ives. Or if you want to watch the whole thing, you can just go to YouTube and do a search Steve Jobs Celebration, or get the QuickTime version from apple.com.
That's right. So until next week, you can contact me, Glenn, at AussieTechHeads.com.au, Eric or Will at AussieTechHeads.com.au, Eric on the Twitter at Eric Franco, and me at AussieTechHeads. All right, everyone. Thanks for calling into the lounge, you guys in the lounge. Thanks very much. Thanks for downloading. Thanks for listening. And yeah, good stuff. See you all next episode. See you later, Eric, and bye for now.
See you guys. Thanks, Glenn.